Hey buddy, it's Invicta. It's time for Wacky Wednesday here on the channel. Today, you might be confused by the visuals of this video, but yes, indeed, this is still Repentance and actually is part of an awesome new mod that I just found on the Steam Workshop. It's called The Binding of Isaac Reflashed, and essentially what it is a graphics substitution mod that basically flashifies everything. So everything that we remember way back in Vanilla Isaac has been brought to Repentance now by an amazing mod. I've not actually played it before, but I've seen a couple screenshots on the Steam Workshop, which you can find a link to down below. Definitely go check it out because I think this is going to be a lot of fun. They also imported a lot of the old sounds, as well as you can hear in the background, the Danny B soundtrack into Repentance. So I'm looking forward to this. We're just going to be doing a regular Eden run, but it's going to be reflashified, and I think that's going to be pretty awesome as well. And if you want to see more of these type of mods, then please let me know by clicking the like button down below. I would appreciate it. Here's your meme of the day here, brought to you once again by Discord. Title of the, not thread, but title of the message from Gray. I think it's Gray. It might be Gree. Title thread was, started this a while ago, but just finished her today. Detective Lil Sissy. I love it. I love the pipe and the monocle and everything about this one. Definitely check out the full resolution if you are on our Discord, on the Mosh Pit Discord. All you have to do is just be a member of the Patreon or a member of the Twitch Mosh Pit or the YouTube Mosh Pit here and check it out for yourself. Thank you very much, Gree. All right, here we go. I'm going to switch over to Eden. As you see here, everything has been flashified. I mean, even all the sprites on the character carousel here, as you see the font, I mean, everything looks and sounds great. And we're just gonna see how this looks. And if you want to see more of this mod, like I said, leave me a comment down below or just let me know by clicking the like button. Oh, wow. Also, really quickly, I should mention that part of this mod, you actually have to increase the max render scale in the options.ini folder. That is to get the quote, true flash experience. That's something that the developers of the mod had put inside of their info page. Again, you can find that down below just by clicking the link in the YouTube information box. Seed day is going to be Juliet Sierra 2 Quebec Charlie Bravo Hotel 9. We've got Bird's Eye and that's about it. Bird's Eye and the Book of Shadows. There we go. Wow, this looks really strange. Oh, wow, look at that. That is not usual fire from Flash, but that is the tears. Oh my gosh. Now, one thing I will say already is that this is incredible because you never got to see the Flash graphics in 60 FPS. So, yeah, this is, like, really, really awesome. We never, ever get to see those old-school graphics. I mean, you're always seeing them at, like, 20, maybe 25, 30 frames a second if you're lucky. But here we go. And then there's also a couple other mods that you have to download with this mod pack. Including one for the mini map, as you see right there. So that's a neat little. I like that little animation there. Pick up a soul heart. We'll get a $3 bill, and yeah. Oh my gosh. So not all of the sprites have been flashified. As you can see here, the flies have, and a lot of there's the bomb as you just saw right there, and the keys as well, the diglets, and basically everything that was inside of Flash Isaac has been reflashed, and then some of the sprites have not. I can tell by the fat Isaacs and stuff, but what I'm really curious about to see is going to be whether or not we get a flashified boss. Now, obviously, look at the heart, too. Man, it looks so, so good to see the old-school graphics at 60 FPS. So, and again, I know that this isn't, like, all that wacky of a Wednesday because it's, you know, we're still just doing a regular Eden run at the same, we're just doing a regular Eden run, but I did want to check this one out because it was very highly rated on the Steam Workshop, and it just looked cool. This, honestly, oh man, look at the old graphics. Almost got hit by the fly just by sitting there staring at the old rotten meat. Now, I do think that everything else in Repentance is still going to be the same. So, like, if we find the secret room, which should be here, we don't have to actually use another bomb to get back in. Oh, wow, look at that. Yeah, this is the old secret room, all right. Is it going to... Okay, yeah, so as you see here, it doesn't make us bomb our way in. Those of you who don't know, if you haven't played the Flash version of Isaac, you actually had to re-bomb yourself back into the secret room, even if you had found it and opened it. Oh, look at the sacks. That's pretty cool. Oh, you know what? Mom's bracelet got an update, too. That's neat. I wonder how many items have been actually updated. I wonder if it's all of them. That'd be insane. So I just love how smooth that animation is on the mini map. I like that. So all right, well, here we go. Dude, I'm pumped. Actually, let's take care of this poop real quick. Might be able to get lucky and get a couple extra things. So as you see here, the dips have not been updated. There's the old penny animation. Oh god, I love that. This is so cool, man. I'm legit like geeking out right now, because like it's just like what we always wanted was like the old school Isaac, but in like 60 FPS basically. And just for the record, let me look at my INI folder here, or INI file. I changed the max render scale to 4. The developer said they recommended 4 or 5 on the max render scale in the options.ini folder, which you can find in your installation directory for Isaac. I put it to 4 just because I don't want to render it too far or too short. I'm not exactly how the render scale actually affects the mod. But normally you play that like 1 or 2 usually. I think mine was set to 2. So you heard the old school sound effect with the Book of Shadows there, with it getting a full charge. Just even hearing the Zodiac, hearing the old tear effects, like whenever Isaac shoots is already nostalgic enough. And it looks like we got Sagittarius here as our first effect from Zodiac. Those bomb spiders, though, now those were different. These regular leapers are not, but those were. Oh, look at the Psytrite. Definitely want to get if we can get a bomb for the Tinted Rock, that'd be great. You know, just because we got a new school, old school paint here doesn't mean that the fundamentals change. Still hoping for a devil deal. Look at the old troll bomb. Oh, that's so cool. So neat, man. Chariot card. Look at that. Hey, it's the old chariot card. Oh, man, this is great. Ooh, careful there. Careful now. But, yeah, I mean, we've been doing a little bit more mod work lately for the last couple of Wacky Wednesdays. I know a lot of people really enjoy the Pokemon mod. I know still a lot of people still want to see more of the Pokemon mod, and that's definitely something that I'm going to be bringing back more of. Oh, there he is, old school Dookie. Old Dookie. There you go, Bird's Eye just completely making short work of old Dookie. We get PJs, which is going to give us a ton of soul hearts. Oh, look at the old Satan. The old Satan statue, man. I'm going to pass in the Book of Sin as well as Jello. Jello also got a resprite as well. That's so cool, man. That's so, so sick. We don't really need the... We can go in the curse room. We don't really need the shop, especially with only one key. You know, you could make an argument that we could go find a bomb to maybe go get that Tinted Rock, but we just got PJs, which is going to give us an absolutely massive amount of HP to work with. So, although, well, there's a chest there, too. Maybe we will go find the shop, because we could get that bomb back. Stone chest. Obviously, stone chest did not exist in Flash Isaac. At least I don't remember them existing in Flash Isaac. We got the old sack room. Look at the skulls, man. It's so neat. Ah, yes, the old trites. My old nemesis. And, of course, there's no bomb. All right. I don't know. There's something so smooth about that animation that just gets me every single time. So, we can go in the curse room here. Okay, good. Use the Book of Shadows to get out. We could have gone in there for free had I used the Book of Shadows and the Chariot card, but meh. It's a little bit of a waste just to save a half soul heart. Would have loved to have gotten into that that Tinted Rock, though. But unfortunately, there was no bomb inside of the shop. And there's not going to be a bomb in here either, but I'm just looking for soul hearts. Maybe we can get another heart. Or not. That's fine, too. All right. So we might be going Angel Deals here. We'll see. That first Devil Deal was not convincing enough. Old school caves. Look at the textures. Oh, look at that. The dips and the dingles got a little bit of an update there, which is weird because we've already seen one of them earlier and the sprite wasn't updated. So that's interesting. But maybe they just have to, maybe it depends on the level. I'm not sure. Room looks very odd in the old school flashified graphics. Now, the Zubats also did not get a didn't get a palette swap, at least not yet. Or skin swap, whatever it would be. Heard the boing? That was the Book of Shadows getting a full charge. Yeah, there's the old school Chargers looking very, very odd and mean. They look a lot scarier in the old school Ed version than they do in Rebirth and Beyond. Chop obviously is there, but we don't care. We need to get rid of one of the Claudies. Still have Sagittarius as our Zodiac item, so I'm fine with that. Also notice how there's a huge lack of an item counter over there on the right side. And obviously that was deliberate. There's Black Hole. Black Hole getting a little sprite swap as well. Secret room could be between the shop and that extra room there, but with only one bomb, I'd rather use these for I'd rather use it for like a tinted rock or something. Like that last four. The corn dips. There's the regular troll bomb. Kind of looks like a mega troll bomb. There's the bomb flies. Now those did exist back in Flash Isaac. And how many of y'all have been watching the channel since we used to do Flash Isaac runs? Post them in the comments down below. I'd love to know how many old school Isaac Victor fans are there. We still have people who used to watch back in the day from League of Legends and Heroes of the Storm and even beyond that, like the old school GeoGuessr stuff. Yeah, it's great seeing all the old icons on the map. Now this is definitely going to be the secret room down below here. And again, you should never ever use your last bomb until you're absolutely sure that you don't need it anymore. But we just got another bomb here, so turns out it's not going to be there. I think I was right early on, and it's so weird that these sprites keep switching back and forth. Not sure why that is. I have restarted the game since installing the mod, as instructed by the mod itself. There we go. Secret room, a super secret room might be to the left of there. It probably is. There we go. We get a golden key. Doesn't really help us out, but thanks for showing up. Gonna be Stain. So Stain obviously did not get a update. Did we get hit there? I think we actually took damage from something. Was it? Apparently Stain hit us right before we used the unicorn card. Or the chariot card, I mean. It is a little bit jarring seeing the pixelated like Repentance Rebirth bosses and then the smooth old school graphics on the Diglets. A little bit jarring. I haven't even talked about our stats yet. Yeah, I was looking at our stats there, Diglett. Okay, all right. Let's get double tapped here. An angel deal. Hey, look at that. It's the old school growth hormones. And we get Genesis. Yeah. I will definitely take that, although I don't know how many items we have. Let's see. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 5 rollable items right now. That was Black Hole in there. So, yeah. So, Genesis, we'll probably wait for a couple more items before we use it. Now you talk about some good rerolls here. Genesis is definitely going to be very welcome. I don't know what we got for Zodiac. We don't have Sagittarius, obviously. I don't know if we have Leo. No, we don't have Leo. I don't think it's Pisces either. We don't have a bomb, so we can't get that. That was the old school Isaac hit there as well. And now we have the old school Isaac head turrets and the old school hosts as well. Looks so cool. I miss the old vanilla Isaac graphics. I really do. And this is one way to sort of like just get that feeling back of you know, of challenge and difficulty and all that stuff. I mean, you know, Flash Isaac was not, it was not an easy game at all. I mean, and Isaac is not an easy game either, obviously, but yeah, there was something about the way that, the old school Isaac played that made it even more difficult. And I think it had to do with the graphics. But, you know, now there's no excuse because everything is running at normal, you know, rebirth and beyond frame rate. So this is like a, you know, almost a dream come true for us old school Isaac players to see all those old school graphics, but in glorious HD and great in non-20 FPS. Seriously, if you haven't played the original Flash Isaac, you need to go back and check it out, and you'll feel our pain. It's like every time I go back and just do like a random Flash Isaac run, it's like how did we do it? How did we go on with our lives sitting there recording these videos of like the 4:3 ratio Isaac? I mean, it was brutal back in the day. Bird's Eye, we need you to step it up, son. That's not the sound that you make. Slowly sort of giving away a lot of our HP here, and I want to get it back. Oh man, look at the old Soul Heart. The old Soul Heart animation. Definitely take that. Old Soul Heart sound effect as well. Ooh. I think it's funny how Genesis only has because it's a single charge, or because it's, I mean, there's no charge on it, obviously, but because it's only a one-time use, the old school graphics only show it having one charge. I think it's pretty neat. We still need to go back and find the item room, of course, and that requires us doing what's called a Sinvicta full clear. Those of you who are part of the uninitiated who watch these videos. They're called Sinvicta Full Clears, and it's the idea that somehow, some way, we manage to basically do a full clear of every level, no matter if we're trying or not. Most of the time, we're not, because the more items or the more rooms that you go into, the higher the chance is that you're going to take damage. That's just how it works. So later on, especially in a bad run, you know, doing full clears can be very detrimental and dangerous, and also it's not good for time either. Robo Baby. Robo Baby's a bro. Gives us some long range piercing shots, which is always great. Could go in the cursed room, might as well. The old school demons. Oh man, the old school bomb flies too. It's so cool. I like this, man. This is really neat. It was a great idea and executed really, really well as well. Again, check out the link in the information box down below if you would like to download this. Just remember that there are multiple mods that you have to download. It's not just the reskin. Like, there's a bunch of them. So it's regular Mega Maw, but he's got the old school fires, which is kind of jarring. A little bit funky. Definitely need some tears. Definitely need some damage here. Oh, look at that! It's the old leapers. I don't know where those sound effects are coming from, though. That is not what Mega Maw sounds like. Get a range upgrade. Range upgrade. All right, so now we start looking at the operative question of when do we use Genesis? And the answer is probably after Womb 1, the Womb 1 boss, because that's going to be the last time that we're going to realistically get ourselves another Angel Deal or Devil Deal. Here, there, we got the old school Brimstone sound effect too, and boy, do I miss that. We are now down officially to only one Soul Heart after having like five of them. Been taking lots of little chip damage here and there. Without getting anything else. We haven't seen anything that resembles a Tinted Rock since the second floor. where Robo Baby's going to really come and help us out. Again, with those long-range shots. I still don't know what Zodiac has given us here. It's not Taurus, and it's not Pisces. It's not Libra. It's not Sagittarius. It's not Scorpio. Maybe it's Virgo. Maybe. That's the only one that would be kind of hard to spot. I'm not going to use our keys for the golden chests here. The secret room might be there. We have six bombs, but let's go for confirmation. I'm definitely like not a huge fan of how much bigger the leapers are. All righty. Let's stop taking damage. How about that? Saved ourselves a bomb here. I am thoroughly unhappy with how much damage we have taken here. All right, well, there goes our angel deal. It is Virgo. A little too late for us to realize that. We do get the damage shield, but that is how you lose a devil deal. Oh, apparently there's creep still there. We're just on tilt now. Tractor beam. Tractor beam got a sprite update as well. At least we got a tears up. You can see the old school trinket down below as well. Although petrified poop didn't exist back in the day. And champion belt would definitely be most welcome here. So I'm going to get champion belt just to give us some damage. And we still could go open up those two golden chests in the challenge room. We might as well. Hopefully, if anything, we get like maybe. Oh, never mind. We can't. We're not full HP. That's what was I thinking? Well, at least we got a tears up from tractor beam. That's the important thing. There's a nickel there. Yes, we do want to trade a bomb for a key. Just can't be bothered with this room. Perfect block by that needle there. Two needles, actually. We've already found the secret room. Looking for the super secret room. Yeah, so that is the old turret sound from way back in the day. Tractor beam makes it a little bit difficult to curve our shots here, but we still get to get the job done. Again, Robo Baby helping us out with the unlimited range. There's a Screaming Fetuses. Still a great band name, by the way. Okay, so we could go into the challenge room. I'm not going to at this point. Obviously, the Sisters Vis are not going to get a... I mean, if Stain didn't get one, then, like, yeah. And then there goes our... Any shot of possibly eking out a 16% special door. Pageant boy. All right, so one more floor. Whoa, that was the old. That was like a manipulated, like old. I don't actually. You know what? I'm not even sure if that was the original mom voice there. It sounded like it for a second, but then it sounded like it was like pitched down a little bit. That was a little bit strange. Yeah, that's definitely not the that's not the original mom voice. They didn't have the mom hands from back in the day, although the mom did. We have Virgo again. No, we have Stompy. I'm gonna take it anyway. Got Leo. The mom hands did not exist back in Flash Isaac. The chariot card, okay. Funnily enough, I think Isaac's sprite actually stayed the same. Even though we took the one that makes you smaller. I gotta mess with it. Try to get the soul heart here. And it's a green fight. For some reason, we have a double boss HP bar. I'm not quite sure why, but you know what? We're just gonna roll with it. Alright. So we actually somehow almost made boss rush. Which is, like, remarkable, considering that we don't have a whole lot to work with right now. Bloody Penny. We need to go back and find our item room. Look at the statues here. So these two were substituted because obviously they existed back in the day, but this one didn't. Yeah, the triple statue. From what I remember, anyway. I could be wrong. It's been so long since I played Flash Isaac. It's a little bit hard to tell, but we actually do have that black soul heart. I know that it looks like that's an empty heart container there, but that's actually a black soul heart from that the mom hand room. This is a tinted rock right there.
Yep.
A little bit tough to see. Okay, they're looking for our item room here. Oh, look at that, the Dinga actually got an update. This is our tinted skull. So if we want a free fool card, go ahead and grab it. At least Leo does save us the need for bombs. It's so weird seeing those moving at a normal frame rate. So we're hoping that Genesis can help us pull out of the sort of tailspin that we're in right now. We're not really in like a nosedive per se. It's just it's rough going right now with this DPS. Missing out on that devil deal definitely hurt us the most. But that's what Genesis is going to be for, hopefully anyway. And stop going in the wrong direction.
All right, there we go. There's the entire map, everybody, except for the one place that we're looking for. Let's go find that item room. Here it is.
I'm only taking Guillotine because I am looking for reroll fodder with Gemini. And a health down. All right. Oh, and there's a spike rock there, too. I couldn't see it because of... it doesn't matter.
All right.
So let's go see if we have the old school mom. Yep. Now that is the old school mom voice. Wow, it is very hard to see where the shadow is going to be landing. I think this is Red Mom. Okay, I'm gonna take the negative just for the damage upgrade, and we can't even take Delirious because it's a space bar item. I was really hoping that we were going to get at least one passive item that from the Angel deal that we could have re-rolled, but Yeah. Old school Diglett graphics here. Now, we did get Libra on this floor. I can tell that because our movement speed and our tears rate increased. So we've got Libra. But again, after we're done with this floor, we're going to use Genesis. And honestly, we don't have a whole lot of items to roll through, which is kind of a bummer. We got some Mega Larrys up in here. They should be dropping us a Soul Heart. They did. Fool's Gold. That's pretty neat how they kind of cell shaded the Fool's Gold rocks there. Purple Heart, which we were not be taking. Stuck. And Guillotine serves as the ultimate distraction. Again, when you're so used to look at the old school Globins. When you're used to basically Isaac's hitbox and the origin point of all of Isaac's shots, when you're used to those that coming from the center of his body, makes it very, very disorienting and distracting whenever you've got something like Guillotine where Isaac's head is rotating around a certain point, but his hitbox is not where his head is. This is going to be a little bit trickier with the old school graphics here. Oh, did it. We need to not hear that sound effect ever again. But despite that being a skull, that is the mini boss skull. Whoa, what is going on in this room? I think there might be a little... Something might be slightly broken in that room. That's okay. Oh, apparently we got hit there. Okay, there we go. All right, Genesis. We're going to need you to lift us up. Binky, and we're going to go to the next floor, and then we're going to use Genesis. So, oh, we have Gemini here. All right, Genesis, here we go. Get ourselves a fresh run. Golden key. Doesn't really matter. Unfortunately, though, this is going to take us up. We actually needed to go to Shoal, but that is that's the risk that you take with Genesis. Contagion. We're not going to get that many items here because we didn't pick up a whole lot of items. Ooh. I'm going to take Pentagram. We need damage here. So this is Synth Oil, even though it looks very similar to Speedball. Yeah. Growth Hormones for sure. Little Chest. We have Vade Retro for our Space Bar item, which is... We'll take the Book of Revelations. Inky again. Oh, I thought that was Montezuma's Revenge. Spider Bite's good. And yeah, that's it. So, a little bit of a lackluster Genesis roll, but unfortunately we have the negative, which means that we won't be able to go to Shoal here because we got taken here by Genesis. Hey, there we go. So what I might do is just teleport us down to Shoal. Just so we could see like the old school Satan. I want to see actually if Lamb actually has a palette swap too, but we can beat Isaac and then we just won't go into the chest. Let's say that thanks to Genesis, we definitely came out ahead here in terms of stats. We're also 2 of 3 for Spun, which is good. That was actually the old school Conquest and War voice there. Ta-da! Contagion has not been animated. They just explode. I think that's kind of cool. Look at the old blorbs. Just everything was so much like more colorful and like brighter in the Flash version. Like it was like cleaner looking, you know. Six daddy long legs? Wow. You don't see that too often. You saw Contagion there explode and they just kinda turned into green goo. Alright, we got a charge in the Book of Revelations. Not gonna go into the curse room, obviously. I don't think it's gonna be worth it at this point. Thank you, charge baby. That is a mimic chest, obviously, so we're going to be leaving that one behind. Oh, it's the old Widow! Old Widow and old Monstro and old Chub. Those are the ones that are... Those are the bosses to me that are iconic enough to remember. Old Widow especially. Like, anytime I see... Oh, my God. Contagion just went ham. Anytime that I see Old Widow, it reminds me of watching Frag from way back in the day. Lethal Frag. Used to fight Widow all the time, and I'm like, oh my god, it looks like such a difficult boss to fight. Unironically difficult. That was the old Monstro sound effect there. Spider Bite. It's a little slow there by Spider Bite. Whoa there, Daddy Long Legs. You are dead, sir. For a second, I thought that was the candle wax skulls that were making that growling sound. Old Isaac heads, old angel fetuses, so good. I love that they managed to get the old school like wall textures back too, but still have like all the repentant stuff on the ground. What? I just can't be bothered. There's a Psyhorse. I don't remember Psyhorse being in regular Isaac. The deacons and the blue holy. Oh, apparently there was fire there. Fire is just invisible. Got it. Well, that adds a little bit of a hazard here. Yeah, there's a fire there, but you wouldn't know it. Oh, yeah. Okay. Secret room, it might be there. Yeah, we get one of our soul hearts back, thankfully. Yeah, it looks like they didn't animate blue fires, I guess. That might be something for the developers to take note of. Again, I think this mod is pretty new. I don't remember seeing it last week on the Steam charts for the workshop. I'm fairly sure it's pretty new. But they did an awesome job. Like, shout out to the mod makers. This is excellent. Excellent. Minus maybe a couple of graphical hiccups and animations. I'd say it's almost flawless. Old school bonies. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna fight Isaac. It's probably gonna be the Flash version of Isaac. No, it's not, actually. It's a little bit disappointing. If you're wondering where we got the full charge from, it's from our hairpin trinket. Whenever you get to the boss room, you automatically get a full charge on your spacebar item. That was not the result of Charge Baby. They did preserve the old Isaac sound effects, though, which is a little bit strange to see here. So what we're going to do is we're going to beat Isaac, then we're going to teleport down to Shoal by using the console command. Because I want to see what Stanley and Lamb look like. We'll probably call it a good video there, I think. No need for a victory lap. Whoa, look at the ground being scorched by Crack the Skizzle. That looks pretty cool. That looks actually really cool. I find it strange that we don't have the doubled boss HP here. Like we did on all the other ones. Now it goes Isaac, and then we're going to teleport to stage, I think it's 10. Here we go. Lots of soul hearts. I do love how they just explode in one giant fart bubble. A pile definitely wasn't in old school Isaac. There we go. It's nice that we have two soul hearts in the bank there. Nice little double kill there by a little chub. Yeah, we can go to the curse room. We've got the two soul hearts in there. Well, thankfully, we were able to get out before the iframes went away. We have another full charge. We actually have a couple full charges coming up on our Book Revelations. When we get the full charge here, then also when we go fight Stanley, we're going to get another one. So we're probably not going to need keys on the next floor. So, yeah. All right. Look how smooth that animation is. I love that. I'm still geeking out about just how cool it is to see everything run at like a full solid FPS, 60 FPS, I mean, despite being old school graphics. Really, really neat. The old Loki. And the old Loki sound effects. I sound like you're just having a party down there. Like, oh! Oh! Woo! Loki's always sounding like he's having a good time. I'm not even sure what Loki is supposed to be honest. Some people say he's a devil cat. Some people say he's just a little devil or like a demon. Just fallen. Oh, that's the old school. That was the old school Satan effect almost. Yeah. Unfortunately, he's not going to drop anything, though. Here's the soul suckers. As we can see the brimstone effect there. Yeah, I don't know what that is. I'm just going to go ahead and not be in there. That was terrifying. Glass eye, which is going to give us the damage up. All right. Nice little freeze there by Spider Bite. Froze that walking host just enough for us to take advantage of him being exposed and end up sniping him there. Again, it just happened again. Spider Bite getting clutch shots. the fart sound effect with them just exploding into nothing is just the greatest. Please keep that in. That's actually like legit hilarious. There's a lot of soul suckers here. Go back and pick up that other soul heart. I'm hoping that the chest can, or at least the dark chest can give us some good hookups here. It's been a fairly, I'd say fairly mediocre Eden run. It's about as run as the mill as you get, but what's made it special, obviously, is the mod and the fact that Contagion is just blowing everything up and then not leaving any corpses or anything. It's just a fart cloud in the wind. I'm all for it. That's great. Looking forward to seeing the meaty leg of Satan here. The floor texture is a little bit funky there, but we'll just ignore that. Of course, I didn't have a bomb to drop here, so you saw that we did get the full charge thanks to the hairpin. Okay, so far that is not the old Satan. That's still the rebirth Satan. That is the old school Satan sound effect, though. Come on, show us the leg. Oh, it's still the same one. Oh, that's a shame. I was hoping to see the old school Satan leg, man. That was the big old meaty goat hoof. That's strange too, because we got the mom replacement. Oh my gosh, I don't know what's going on there, but a little bit worried. We've gone to the dark room, and I'm not expecting to see any palette swaps in terms of the ground or anything like that, because obviously the dark room didn't exist back in the day. We get Brimstone and Abadabba Ding Dong. So are we going to get the old school Brimstone effect or not? Yep. Oh, man, that's so good. So good. We're not going to be doing any damage, but oh, that's so great. You can get Pogatory here. It is a little strange seeing Void with just nothing in the background. But I guess it's more of a void now than it ever has been. There's just no walls. It's just a void, really. It is interesting though that Contagion and the fart explosions are now animating correctly. So maybe there was something screwy on my installation or something. Let me know. Post in the comments down below if you've downloaded this mod and you've seen the same thing for yourself. But if this is a new mod, if it's as new as I think it is, then I'm sure the developers will be all over it. But this one's definitely worthy of a checkout. I don't know why Brimstone's shooting off into the corner like that. We don't have the analog stick, so we shouldn't be able to shoot off in the diagonal directions there. I'm not even doing it with the keyboard. It's just happening. A little bit strange. There we go. Back to full HP here, courtesy of the full charge we just got. Oh my god. The whole world's exploding in here. Was a little bit strange there. That was like a little bit of a jerky hesitation animation there. The old wretched. There she is, the old widow. Yep, and those are the old widow sound effects too. Widow was the first ever boss that I saw in the Binding of Isaac, that I saw Frag fight. Oh, and we got to see Chubb. Right at the last room, we get to see old Chubby. She's not buttless, Chub, but she'll do. Look at her. Look at her. So good. All right. Well, obviously, Lamb is not going to have a palette swap because he didn't exist back in the day. But you should definitely check out this mod for yourself if you're interested. Again, check out the link down below. Really, really fun, awesome mod. Very, very well executed. I'm impressed, thoroughly impressed with how smooth everything ran and, you know, all the sprite updates that we did see, or I should say maybe, like, down dates that we've seen. Were really impressive. I would love to hear the actual Danny B soundtrack. I know that you can download that, obviously, for Repentance, but it'd be neat if it was included in this one. Maybe there was some, I don't know, maybe there's some licensing or copyright issues with it. I'm not sure. Either way, check out the link down below. And if you enjoyed this mod, everyone, make sure you click that like button, leave a comment, all that kind of good stuff. And thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing, everybody. What a fun mod that was. Again, one final time, check it out. And as always, see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. Like, thanks to patrons of mine like Barman1988, Flots Callen Canstony, and RavenWolf45. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.